Okay, today I'm doing a maintenance Kohler generator. Again, it's like every few days. So, I know my GoPro doesn't show this too well, so I figured I would show this control, well, the interface that I have on the SiteTech that I'm able to connect to the system with. Now, as you can see, as we start off, it lets you know the brands, lets you know the controller that I have in there, the firmware. And I'm actually going to be updating the firmware. It's going to let me know my engine speed is at 3600 RPM, which is what the generator has to run at to produce a clean 60 hertz. Oil pressure, I can't read anything. My target speed is 3600. I'm right on there, but I'm not far off. Battery voltage, 38.8. My oil temp is 55. It was 37 when I started, because it's 37 degrees out here right now. My genset controller temperature is 63 because it's above the engine, so the heat of the engine is warming it up a little bit. My engine speeds, I'm not going to be making any adjustments with those. Close down the menus I don't need. Now my metering on my generator. I'm producing 239.9 volts on L1 and L2. I'm a single phase, so I don't have L2 to L3. As you can see, my generator voltage average to line is about 240. Then I don't have any current at all right now. I'm not powering the house. I have zero current on it. My frequency is almost 60 hertz. And that's pretty much how the generator controls and operates its speed bias. Look in the key, 60 hertz at all times. You get your genset info, now your runtime. Today is 9, it is 10:45 in the morning, which is actually off, it's actually 9:45. My controller has been sitting here for 54,000 hours and 173. Not sure of the purpose of that, but that's how long it's been protecting the house. Even Generac loves to tell you that number. It's like hours of protection. Now you got the total runtime on this machine, which is 300 and almost 5 hours. It doesn't show total runtime loaded at all here. I don't know why. Engine total number starts. It starts 371 times. The last maintenance was 11/16/2017, so almost a year ago. Engine runtime, month of date, 12-hour format. Let's go down even more. My maximum alternator current, this is 920 amps. No way. There's no way I could handle that, but hey, that's what it's saying. Engine number of flywheel teeth, it's saying 1. Warm up temperature is 90, cool down at 174. What that means is that 174 degrees, this generator is going to go into a cool down. The last video I made, it was hunting within the cool down, so that meant I got the generator over 174 degrees, and then it started hunting in the cool down mode, and I was able to correct that just by changing an advanced speed gain. The engine crank disconnect speed is 750 RPMs. Now the idle speed is 2700. I don't recommend doing a low engine speed test. It sounds like it's stalling the whole time there. The engine run speed, it's always looking for 3600. The coolant temperature, unfortunately there is no coolant. So that's just like, it's there in case the machine has these features. I don't have these features, so none of this stuff really matters. What I should actually do is load it up, and you'll see some of those things actually come to life. My configuration is for 240 volts at 60 hertz. I'm a single phase unit. It's a 20 kW, but seriously, it's really only an 18 kW running on natural gas. 75 amps is my genset rated current. Display contrast is at 20. Now, this is the interesting thing. The maximum percentage capacity is only set for 70%. Because you do not want to cook your motor. You don't want to be overloading. Your overload protection is at 85%. Your under frequency shed level is at 50 hertz. If you go down 5, you're going to shed if you have a low shed device. Here are the speed gains, which are already set up on this. I'm going to voltage regulator gains, different engine timings that I can change and play with, protection. That's more if I have problems I can get into it, but I don't have to right now. This is where I get my warnings, low battery warning, delay. High battery voltage warning. And you find that you open it up and it's got that little light blinking and you got a problem. Engine lock, rotor shutdown, delay 3 seconds. Low engine speed shutdown limits 85% of what it's looking to put out. Your genset high engine speed shutdown. And yeah, low engine 85% of its 3600. High engine speed if it overcranks. All your digital inputs and outputs, protection on your generator, for all the faults that might pop up if you have a problem. And we have digital inputs and outputs here, for whatever you want, your inputs and outputs to control. Your ATS metering, this is your automatic transfer switch, it can't tell my contactor position. If I had an internet connected, I'm connected by a remote, so I'm wired in. Okay, ATS exercise, weekly 20 minutes, and unloaded full speed test we're doing here. My automatic transfer switch delay. Transfer from preferred delay is 3 seconds. My automatic transfer from standby delay is 120 seconds. That means that I'm switching back out. And my engine start delay is 3 seconds. I don't have anything really connected to my mod buses or any of this other stuff. I would have to be connected to the internet for any of that to work. It's going to be on queue setup. But it's not. Okay, let's get back into the top part. Yeah. Oh, our metering. Still putting out 240 at 60 hertz. Top. Engine metering. So right now our engine loop temp is 136 and the controller temp is 72. I like to warm it up so this way the oil drains out pretty quickly for me. I can't stop the machine though from here, so do is I'm going to update the firmware to the latest version. Okay, firmware is updated. Let's give it a second to connect. See, it's going to start pulling in all the history down at the bottom, the event history. going to have to find out from the homeowner when he would like his machine to operate its weekly test. My speed gains are still set. Sometimes it erases it, but what I can do is from here is start an exercise. But I can't actually do much more. If I make changes, I gotta hit apply change. Is it not letting me? Let's see. It used to let me do it. For whatever reason, these look great, so I don't think I'm going to be able to. Let me just check out. I don't think I have an exercise set up. So, gen set systems, configuration, and speed. No, they're not letting me start it from here. They used to. Unless I'm off, not in auto. Oh, okay, I gotta come back to my controller now that I made those changes. English. 10:55. It's hard to see the time. I'm using my phone as a camera. 9:56. Future, we'll do 12. Twelve forty looks good. But that was a time and date. Time and date. November 9th. Okay. 9:56. Good. 12-hour format. Return. Exercise full load. Okay, now let's see. Let's go back to auto. It's always got to be in auto or else it's not going to work correctly. I'm just going to want to start. It's in Eaton, so I'm not going to be able to do a full loaded test here. Yeah, full speed exercise. Now I'm starting from here. There we go. Generator, turn it on. I can make changes to even though I don't want to.